I know some of you might be disappointed that I'm going to talk about OU football stuff now because we've been having so much fun with the SEC talk. It's just been nonstop in the Big 12 drama, but I figured I'd take a break and talk about OU football. What a shock. So, fall camp begins on Friday, and this is one of those last few times where in the off season where it's like, okay, this is like one of the big things. Fall camp, here we go. You just want to get through it alive. And what I mean by that is last year, going into fall camp, it like you add COVID to the mix. Things were not going well. Lost two potential key starters on the defense to injury of Caleb Kelly and Justin Harrington. Just didn't go well. Wasn't a good start to everything. And the start of the season, they kind of carried over to that as well. So you want to have a good fall camp. You want to get guys in and out healthy. You want to figure out, you know, what's your offensive line rotation? Who's going to play, you know, corner, defensive back, you know? You know, I think your front seven is looking good right now, but offensive line is probably my biggest, wouldn't say concern, but my biggest question mark, who's going to fill those spots? And I know someone in the comments is already typing, have you heard about Wanya Morris and his stuff? Or I've heard, I've read, we'll just have to wait and see what happens. It doesn't sound like it's someone's beating him out for the job. It sounds like it's a technical complicated issue. We just got to wait and see what happens. With Marcus Major, I know Marcus Major is out there. There are so many different like rumors about Marcus Major. I've lost track. And at this point, I'm just not even going to hold out hope right now. So we are going to run with the three guys, Trey Bradford being third, and Kennedy Brooks and Eric Gray being your one and two, respectively. Those could flip. But we have, those are your three guys at running back. Let's just leave it at that. And there might be a walk-on in the depth chart at this point, so be prepared for that. But, you know, you want running backs just to get through healthy in fall camp as well, and the season. So, anyway. But offensive line, you know, I think that's going to be good to go overall regardless. I think Anton Harrison's ready to take one of those spots, possibly left tackle. Andrew Rame, looking forward to seeing what he does. Sounds like he's going to be center. We'll see what happens there. Chris Murray is going to take a spot. Marquise Hayes. I feel pretty good overall about the O-line. Just, it all depends. Like, when we see that first game against Tulane on ABC, you know, here's the starting lineup of who's plugged in where. And knowing our coaching staff, it's not going to match what they gave the graphics department. And we'll have to figure it out by watching the game. Wide receivers, hearing nothing but great things about Mario Williams. Get excited about Mario Williams. He is going to take the top off a lot of defenses. And, of course, Marvin Mims returning off of a great freshman year. A little inconsistent at times last year, but, you know, I'll just, like, freshman. But, you know, that guy can also take the top off of the defense. And I want to see what Hazelwood and Weiss do. You know, they've had some up and down years and some, you know, whether it's injuries or inconsistencies, you know, combination of both. And I'm hoping they can, like, finish their career strong these last couple of seasons, and they can make themselves, they can live up to the five-star hype, because there's a lot of hype with those two guys and Bridges, and boy, you know, miss Bridges already, but, you know, it is what it is. But again, we're not lacking for wide receiver talent. You know, we'll see what Drake Stoops does. Always that little X factor there. Looking forward to that. And, you know, we got some transfers too. We got Mike Woods out of Arkansas. Go sub his channel. He's got a YouTube channel. Go sub his channel. Mike Woods is a good dude. And, you know, just wondering how that's all going to work out there. But, yeah, like a lot of talent out there. A lot of talent at wide receiver. Looking forward to that. You know, defensive line. I don't know where to begin. You know, Redmond's back. You know, Perrion Winfrey is like my favorite player on the D-line right now. If he can put together the type of season I think he can have, my God, it's going to be fun. And of course, Nick Bonino coming off the edge is going to be great. And this, the depth behind them is just going to be astounding. Like, linebacker David Agwebu, Sean White, all those guys, just, and Caleb Kelly, you know, with his playing his 27th year at Oklahoma. I'm kidding, of course. But, just the depth and talent we have for this particular roster on defense is sick. Corner, who knows how they're going to work that out. I know it feels like DJ Graham and Woody Washington are your guys, but man, like Justin Harrington and so many other players like behind them. I mean, do they rotate corners? I don't know. You tell me. I'm not a coach. Someone else is a coach. They'll figure it out before I do. You know, Jeremy Crudell's got a lot of hype in the offseason, playing him at nickel potentially, but then you have Billy Bowman, who's Billy Bowman's got a lot to live up to because his girlfriend won a national championship this past year. So he's got a lot, he's got to do something to, like, you know, get even. So, you know, she set the standard. So, Billy, you got to do your part to win a daddy this year. You know, it's up to you. At the safety position, of course, you know, you got Pat Fields and Darren Turner-Yell, who have been the two mainstays for quite a long time. And I know people are hoping someone will take Pat Fields' job. I have nothing against, listen, I've said it before, these two guys have, like, played a lot of football. They've done the best they can do with the space of who they are. But everyone's wanting to see what Key Lawrence does, Bryson Washington. They want to see what some of these new players could possibly bring to the table. So we'll see what happens there. But those are the kind of the questions. Those are the areas I'm looking at in fall camp. You know, special teams, kicking, I think we're all good to go there as well. I haven't talked about quarterbacks because do I really need to bring up Spencer Rattler? I mean, Spencer Rattler is a preseason Heisman favorite to win it, which usually doesn't work out well for eventual Heisman winners. Usually Heisman winners kind of pop up and early on, and then they have big games in October and November. I can make a whole separate video about what Rattler needs to do to win the Heisman. I'll probably do that at some point later this month. But there's a trick to winning the Heisman, and it's you don't want to be that September Heisman guy, because a lot of guys are September Heisman winners, and they get a lot of hype in September, and then they can't top what they did because there's so many other big games down the road that, you know, everyone has like a short-term memory and they just remember the last thing they saw. That's how college football has been working for about 100 years. So, hopefully we can get through fall camp healthy, get everyone we need to get going, and we're about a month away from kickoff, guys, and we'll actually be on national television on a big boy network on the road, mind you, to start off our season. And then hopefully after that we'll be able to play our final pay-per-view game ever against Western Carolina. And then we'll come back home and play Fox Big Sunrise. I mean, sorry, Big Noon Kickoff against Nebraska to finish to round out the non-conference before we go into our final Big 12 conference play. And again, we'll delve deep into that another time. So, a lot of hype for this football team. Someone really hyping them up, like ridiculous hype. Not going to say what it was because you might roll your eyes at it, but if they live up to that hype, I'll say what it is later. But if some people know what I'm talking about, very small few of you know what I'm talking about, but I'm not going to say it here because you will roll your eyes when you hear it. That's just the way it is. Anyway, I'm out of here. Boomer Sooner. Catch y'all later. I'm probably not doing a stream tonight. I might do it tomorrow night. So we'll see how that works. But not Wednesdays. I'm going to move it to Thursdays, like earlier. Probably 8 o'clock-ish on Thursday. So I'm going to try to aim for that. But like Wednesdays are not working out for me anymore. But like last couple weeks have been crazy. So I've kind of had to do it. But with that being said, I'm out. And y'all have a good one.